In this tutorial, we're going to go over the menus in your elegant themes. Now, the menus operate in the same manner regardless of which theme you choose, and this is the navigation menu here. So we're going to manipulate that and get that just the way we want. Now, in order to do that, you log into your website and go down to Appearance and then click on Menus. And this is the section where you can change your current navigation menu or create a new one. If you haven't already created a navigation menu, then what WordPress does, what your WordPress theme does, will just select all of your posts, categories, and all of your pages and put them in the navigation menu. So that's what happens when this navigation area looks cluttered. You need to go in and set up your navigation menu. So you can see here we've already got a menu created, but you can create a new menu if one's not already here. And to do that, you just click on the plus button here and we give the menu a name. We're just going to call this New Main Menu and then click Create Menu here. So there's nothing in our menu yet. What we have to do first is select from our pages and categories that we'd like to appear in our navigation menu. You can also add a custom link here. All you need to do is type the URL of the page. And so, for example, I'm just going to type a link to my website, and you can type a label for that. And if we click on Add to Menu, you can see here it's added a link to home. And if we click on this down arrow here, you can see that's the URL, that's the navigation label there. So other than that, you might like to add a sitemap. So we go down to sitemap in our list of pages. If your page is not showing here under most recent, just click View All and then go down to the page you'd like to add to the menu. Click Add to Menu and you can see here now that it's added a sitemap option. And again, if we open this up, you can see the navigation label there. So go through and add all the pages that you'd like to include in your navigation bar. I'm going to add a contact page. And if we scroll down to categories, we can also add a link to all the categories on our website. So for example, if you have a portfolio and you like people to give people an easy link to your blog, just click blog there. And you can see here now this has added all these links to your navigation menu. Make sure you click Save Menu to save those changes. And the only other thing you need to do to enable that to show on your website is come over to this first box here. And depending on your theme, you may have one menu option, or you might have a primary menu, you might have a secondary menu. Here is where you can select which menu shows where on your theme. So we're going to choose the new main menu that we've just created for our primary menu and click Save. If we now go over to our website and just refresh the page, you can see here now we've got this new navigation menu appearing here. And that's as simple as it is to create a navigation menu for your website. We can also rearrange these pages and add drop-downs. So for example, I'm going to just click on Contact Us and I'm going to drag it to the bottom of the list. I'm going to move the sitemap to below the blog, and that's the changes I'd like to make there. If we click Save Menu, go back to our website and refresh. You can see here now that has changed the order of our navigation menu to the order that we've put in here. Now, under my portfolio, I think I'd like to add portfolio large, so I'm going to add that to the menu. I'm going to add portfolio small, and I'm going to add portfolio no text. So if I was to leave these the way they were, they would just appear in the line of navigation options here. But I'd like them to sit underneath my portfolio link. So all we need to do is click on that option and drag it up under portfolio and just slightly to the right. Again, I'm going to move portfolio large and do the same, and then portfolio text. And then you can see here now that's our main navigation link, and we've got three sublinks underneath. If we click Save Menu and then go to our website and click the refresh button, you can see here now that our portfolio option has those drop down menu options just underneath. So that's how we can tidy up the navigation menu and put options underneath the main headings, the main link headings. And you can do this up to as many different levels as you like. You can create custom links to other websites, you can link to pages, you can link to categories. Just remember to click Save Menu and you're done.